The most amazing thing as I heard Little Hands as they sang, because this is Joy Sunday, and how amazing, and when was the last time that you could not stop your hands from being joyful? Is that not joy and what Christ calls us to? How old were you when you were taught to contain your joy until it was appropriate? And a child shall lead us. So don't hold that joy back. That was just beautiful. Now I'll take my preach off, and here we go. Sorry. We wait, we long, we hold on to God, for love has taken us and shaped a promise in us. Once more, once more, once more.
Once more, once more, once more. A desert blooms, a barren place fills with joy, and God's glory is fully on display. A symphony in joy, in joy, in joy.
In joy, in joy, in joy. God rebalances the world. In mercy, blesses the unblessed. In truth, knocks away at untruth. For justice is born, is born, is born.
Born, born, born. In the deserts is new hope. Fearful souls grasp hold of hope. It is heaven's doing, heaven's doing. Heaven's doing.
It's heaven's doing. Heaven's doing. For heaven is doing a new thing in us, for us. God has remembered, remembered, remembered.
Remembered, remembered, remembered what the prophets have said. God is on the way. The justice blind will see anew. The law deaf will hear a new truth, all will sing a new song, and love streams will flow, will flow, will flow.
They will flow, will flow, and will flow like heaven's mercy through this world. For the child of Israel has been embraced, and we have been remembered. God is on the way, the way, the way.
The way, the way, the way is being opened, the road straightened, for this is God's highway, for God has found a way, a time, and there will be joy, there will be joy, there will be joy.
Amen.
Thank you. I'd invite any children or anybody who's young, feeling young at heart, to come on forward for a time with children today. Come on down. Oh, come on down. Come on down. Good morning. Oh, is that an elf on the shelf? Wow. Good morning. Good morning. How's everybody doing this morning?
Good.
Boys and girls, what is it this week? At the end of this week, what do we celebrate?
Christmas.
That's right. Christmas Eve and Christmas. So today, though, we're not quite to Christmas yet. We're on a week called Advent Joy. But let me tell you that before Jesus was born, things weren't very joyful. The people of Israel had been conquered by enemies and conquered some more, and they lost their houses, and some of their sons and daughters were taken as slaves, and they weren't very happy. In fact, they were ruled by these people called the Romans for over 150 years. And that's older than anybody in this congregation right now. If you think about it, could you imagine your whole life having people tell you where you could go, when you could go, how much money you had to pay? We probably can't imagine that very well, because we've lived in freedom in our lives. Let me give you an example that maybe some of you could relate to. For over 100 years, there was a baseball team in Chicago called the Cubbies. And for years and years and years, they were not good. And every now and then they'd get close, but they'd lose. And the fan base of Chicagoans was like, it's never gonna happen. They're never gonna win. And so people who had lived their whole lives without tasting victory were sad. But then, much to the dismay of anybody from Cleveland, then a World Series happened. The Cubs won. And I don't bring that up to compare so much with Christmas, the Cubs, but to show that men, women, children, grown adults, grandpas and grandmas were hugging and crying in the streets of Chicago and celebrating and saying, my gosh, something that we thought would never happen happened. So for the people of Israel, there were prophets, and they said, God is going to deliver you from your misery.
Stop it.
And when God delivers you, your people will have great joy and rejoicing, and God will bring you light out of your darkness. And the people said, it's never going to happen. And then, just like the Cubs, and then out of nowhere, Mary and Joseph went to Bethlehem, and angels appeared to shepherds in the night sky and said, tonight, this day, God's hope is born to you, and you will have great joy, and you will rejoice, and nothing can take that away, because the thing that you thought was impossible has happened, and God has moved. And that is what we get ready to celebrate this week. Let's pray. God, for joy to the world in Jesus. What a Redeemer, what an amazing, amazing relationship you give us through Christ our Lord. So we pray as we prepare for Christmas and family and presents and all that good stuff, that we also remember that everything we do about Christmas is about Jesus, who brings you near to us and reminds us of your love. Carry that with us this Christmas in Christmas joy. Amen. Thank you, boys and girls.
As our youth head off to Sunday school, we invite you to join in singing hymn number 182, O Come All Ye Faithful, verses 1 and 2.
And as we move into our prayer for illumination, we do remember that Southsiders had known the miracle of victory at least a decade prior to the Cubbies. So miracles happen in Chicago on a regular basis. So, let us be in prayer. Sorry. I just had to. Let us be in prayer. Oh, Creator God, while you forgive me for my sarcasm, you do remind us always that you have flooded us with dreamlike images of the lion lying down with the lamb and justice, rolling in like a mighty river and swords being beaten into plowshares. You have given us images of good news being given to the oppressed, and you say the whole world will rejoice. And when we have hope, we can imagine. And when we imagine, we wonder. And when we wonder, we dare to believe. And when we believe, we live and breathe into those promises. So give us that strength to listen to those promises so we can dream and we can wonder, O God, deep down. And understand that those words you have given are the very thing we need. Let us listen. Amen. Hunter. Thessalonians. I lied. You play, then Hunter reads. Your Sunday, sorry.
Thank you. Hear now these words from 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verses 15 through 24. See that none of you repays evil for evil, but always seek to do good to one another and to all. Rejoice always, pray without ceasing, give thanks in all circumstances, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you. Do not quench the Spirit, do not despise prophecies, but test everything. Hold fast to what is good. Abstain from every evil. May the God of peace himself sanctify you entirely. And may your spirit and soul and body be kept sound and blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. The one who calls you is faithful, and he will do this. Thanks be to God for the inspiration found in these ancient words. Amen. Our second scripture reading comes from the Gospel of Luke, the first chapter, verses 41 through 56. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the child leaped in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit and exclaimed with a loud cry, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And why has this happened to me, that the mother of my Lord comes to me? For as soon as I heard the sound of your greeting, the child in my womb leaped for joy. And blessed is she who believed that there would be a fulfillment of what was spoken to her by the Lord." And Mary said, "My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has looked with favor on the lowly state of his servant. Surely from now on, all generations will call me blessed, for the Mighty One has done great things for me, and holy is his name. Indeed, his mercy is for those who honor him, from generation to generation. He has shown strength with his arm. He has scattered the proud in the imagination of their hearts. He has brought down the powerful from their thrones and lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things and sent the rich away empty. He has come to aid his child Israel in remembrance of his mercy, according to the promise he made to our ancestors, to Abraham and his descendants forever. And Mary remained with her about 3 months and then returned to her home. Thanks be to God for these words on the third Sunday in Advent. Amen.
We phrase it as a sharing of our gifts, an invitation to offering. A sharing of your gift. So what is your gift? Musical ability? The ability to read when asked last minute because someone is ill? Is it kindness? Is it love? Is it joy? Share. Share your gift. What good is your gift if you're just keeping it to yourself? Can you make people laugh? What is your gift? The invitation to offering. If you are generous, be generous. In this moment, but in every moment, what is your gift? Don't keep it to yourself. That's just dull. Share your gift and share it exuberantly. God loves a joyful giver. God will take a grumpy one. But God loves a joyful giver. So share your gift now and in any and every moment. And we invite the ushers to come forward, and we invite the musicians to share their gift.
We invite you to stand for the singing of our doxology.
God, for the gifts that have been given, but also those that stand or are seated or at home in flesh and blood, that we might carry Advent joy with us, not only through a week of the year, but extend it in good news, great joy, hope and light, encapsulating your love. For those who are sick or hospitalized, for those who are going through relationship struggle, for those who are worried or anxious, meet us where we are, but in that great joy and love, continue to create in us the dream you have for each one of us. It's as your people of every age and every size this day, every experience as we've walked through these doors, that we pray the prayer you first taught us, saying together, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Please be seated.
Thank you.
It has been some time since we've been blessed to have a cantata, so I want to thank the music ministry staff, the strings, the singers, the guest singers, the staff, the music staff, for providing joy, Advent joy season through the gift of song. And if any of you would like to join us on Christmas Eve, continue the celebration, you're always welcome here. It's a point, genuinely, always welcome here. And as we celebrate with Advent joy, and I heard that Adoramus Te, I think about the joy of God. It's like having the dissonant sounds of gray in everyday routine become song, like Adoramus Te. It is seeing life fully in a different way, seeing others in a different way. And if you haven't experienced that, I just invite you again this Christmas season to open yourself to it, because the joy of God is something in my earthly life I've never found anything close to replacing. So may the joy found in relationship with God, the peace, the love, and the challenge of taking that into the world, being a source of light for others, sharing good news, sharing joy, sharing peace, be a part of you, be all of you, as we leave this place today, so that Christmas isn't something we celebrate once a year on a calendar, but it's a relationship we carry with us every day of our lives. May God's peace be with you. Amen.